modest little surroundings.
President Hollow, what's your reaction to the Partnership for Peace plan? Do you think it goes far enough?
My sestavíme veľmi príznivý ten plán.
Our attitude to the plan is very favorable. Will you ask President Clinton for more?
To záleží na budúcim vývoji.
That depends on future development. Thank you.
Thank you.
Navštívil prezident Spojených států amerických i tím, že Praha byla zvolena za místo setkání i s představiteli sousedních zemí. Během rozhovoru, které jsme vedli, ať v delegacích nebo sami, jsme dali najevo, že Česká republika vítá projekt Partnerství pro mír, je připravena začít ho naplňovat i hned konkrétním obsahem, považuje ho za projekt vyvážený, dobrý. Zároveň jsme zdůraznili naši vůli spolupracovat i se svými sousedy. Konstatovali jsme příbuznost našich stanovisek s našimi sousedy a zdůraznili jsme, že přikládáme velký význam i spolupráci regionální. Hovořili jsme o různých dalších tématech, včetně spolupráce ekonomické. Tolik zatím za českou stranu.
Thank you very much. First, I want to express my thanks to President Havel for his warm welcome. I'm coming back to Prague only for the second time in my life. I was here 24 years ago in this same week in a very different role in life. I have been deeply impressed by the progress made by the Czech Republic and was deeply impressed by the meeting I had today with the President and with the Prime Minister and with other leaders of the government. I reaffirmed the fact that the security of this Republic and of the nations of Central and Eastern Europe are important to the security of the United States and to Europe and to the Atlantic Alliance. That the Partnership for Peace is the beginning of a genuine security relationship which can lead to full membership in NATO, and that we must also be mindful of the economic dimension of security, where it is difficult for nations to pursue good policies, and to reflect democratic values unless they can also offer the hope of success to people within their borders who work hard, obey the law, and try to contribute to the welfare of society. And so we talked about these things, and I look forward to talking tomorrow with all the leaders who will be here together in perhaps somewhat more specific terms about what we can do to further both these objectives. But I am very encouraged by this meeting tonight, and I thank President Havel for his support for the Partnership for Peace.
Vaše otázky, prosím. Česká televize, pan Kurfürst.
Česká televize, otázku pro oba dva prezidenty. Pánové, domníváte se, že některá z východoevropských zemí by se mohla stát dříve členem Severoatlantické aliance než ostatní?
My rozumíme tomu projektu Partnerství pro mír tak, že to jsou dveře otevřené všem, ale bude hodně záležet na každém, jak rychle těmi dveřmi vstoupí. Je to projekt, který chce jednat individuálně s různými zeměmi.
That issue has not been resolved. So since it was not discussed one way or the other, I suppose it is theoretically possible. NATO is a security alliance in which all the members undertake to assume certain responsibilities for the welfare of the entire group. One of the things I want to emphasize about the Partnership for Peace is that it is a security relationship that will permit immediately the military commanders of NATO to begin to work with the military leaders of each country involved in the partnership, to look at joint training, to look at joint exercises, to deal with a whole range of issues which will help to move toward membership.
President Howell?
Yes, AP, please.
Sir, can you talk, how concerned are you about the rise of ultra-nationalists and communists in the parliamentary elections in Russia? Does that cast a cloud over this region?
Ten vývoj v Ruské federaci je složitý, dramatický, bolestivý a my ho pochopitelně sledujeme se zvýšenou pozorností. Ale pevně věříme, že postupně zvítězí i v Ruské federaci demokracie, tržní ekonomika. Navzdory všem složitým fázím a peripetiím tohoto vývoje.
Oba dva prezidenty čeká další program. Děkujeme vám za vaše otázky, za vaši pozornost. Naschledanou.
Mr. President.
First riser. You go back, crease it on the second riser. Okay? Left side. All the way down. Everyone get it? Thank you.
Partners. on the riser or back?
I mean, you come here, especially in the Czech Republic. Don't you have a sense of anxiety?
Truck's coming through, let's go.
Like to have the same kind of protection. For example, they just don't have
these Germans got into NATO because they
became
in a way that gives other countries the chance to participate. They will all have the best possible for their own integration, where all these countries respect each other's borders. The second best feature is that they should be part of the country. I have told them that I consider their security to be a part of the country. This is the way to revoke the best possible for still hold on to the security.
This part of the world is being reinvented after World War II, at a time when, once again, the United States feels strongly that it has to look
into
the problem within its borders. Will it have a very active role here, or will it be reduced?
I think we will, but I think a lot of
them will all be sitting here tonight.
The difference in now and at the end of World War II, when we had some countries like Germany and Japan that were totally in ruins but had the capacity to grow quickly with proper investment, was that these countries are going through an economic transformation. Here we are in Prague tonight. I'm proud of the fact that the United States is the biggest investor, foreign investor, in this country. We have over $1.8 billion committed in new projects here. So I think what we have to do as a government, we can help them some with direct government expenditures. We can help them with joint military training and preparation, maybe even with some equipment. But what we have to do is to make it easier for trade and investment to occur, because they're going to private economies and the private sector has to be the engine of growth.
I've never known a president yet who didn't come to Europe or go on an international trip and realize the ramifications when you reshape the globe and kind of think, well, gee, maybe I'd rather do this than go back and deal with Congress and deal with the issues of Whitewater or healthcare or all the other things. Do you get that sense on your first trip to Europe as well?
Well, I'm enjoying it a great deal, and I am impressed with the importance of what we're trying to do. But to me, the real lesson of this world we're living in, and certainly the century we're moving into, is that there really isn't a division between domestic and foreign policy anymore. That is, I believe the work I'm doing here in Europe is directly related to the future security and the stability of the incomes of the American people. And by the same token, if we don't address the economic and social problems, healthcare, crime, the other problems we've got at home, we won't have the support at home to lead in the world. So I think, you know, yes, I'm having a good time, but I'm sure looking forward to going home in that session of Congress too, because in order for me to do the right thing by the future of our country, we have to meld our domestic and foreign policy. People have to see themselves as citizens of the United States and citizens of the world.
Finally, there are a lot of young Americans here and a whole lot of speculation about whether or not this new first post-war president, when he comes to Prague, will join them in a pub or in one of the jazz clubs in this town before the night is out.
We may do a little of both. I told President Havel that from now on, my time is his time. We finished our business, so I'm going to go wherever he wants to go. And he's a big, he and I share a love for jazz music, so maybe he'll take me to one.
That's great. Thanks.
Hello.
Thank you.
Courier is going to start over here on the backside of this riser. Unfortunately, all we probably 23 AS is about another 200 yards. This, and then 200 yards is a staircase that goes down.
Down there.
I'm
going to put my bag in. I'm going to carry it and walk.
You guys are supposed to be on that. Hopefully. About yes. Person calling can.
Get out of here,
these guys.
Come on,
next shot, Mark.
Help
out.
Next shot. Next shot. Come on, let's go back.
Get on.
Next shot, guys. Next shot.
Risers, can you see?
Half and half.
Truck, are you? Can you see?
He needs to back it up.
Come on.
Nobody but
you.
Thank
you. Folks,
got a quarter
this way. Guys, hold on. Let's start rolling the truck.
Pause.
Gotta
move, folks.
Get down, y'all.
Come on, Pool.
All right, Pool.
Stop. Jesus.
Let's go, Press.
Boy, that's real fucked up. Hey, where you guys going? Thanks a lot.
Kara, you got a camera behind you.
Thank you, Mark.
Oh, maybe not.
Okay.
Let's go, Pool. We're rolling.
Okay,
we're rolling.
Pool. Keep going, guys.
Let's get it moving.
Move it, Ed. Let's go. Move, Ed. Go.
Stop through us. Let's go, folks. Let's go.
Stop.
Yes, I walked across this bridge.
You can't see it losing the light. Can you guys even see this? Are you losing the light?
I see it. That's all right.
Let's go.
Slow. Kara. Well, where?
Is there a man in the car?
Slow it down just a little bit, Al, okay? Slow down.
King McGuire. King McGuire. Sorry, guys. And of course, this is now the best view to the river in front of me.
This is not good. I've been there.
Slow it down, Ed.
Okay, let's go.
Is there a way through this mob up here?
And where are we supposed to stop?
That's it.
Okay, now we're good. But we're going to go past this place.
I have not found it.
Sorry, we don't go in that.
God, God, Mort.
Mort, Tom. You'll see the position.
Guys, speed it up.
This is one of the oldest sculptures on the left side.
Keep going, Ed. Let's go. Whoa, whoa. Hold up, Ed. Hold up, Ed. Hold up, Ed. Stop, Ed.
Kneel down. Everybody.
Let's go with the truck, Ed.
Let's go with the truck.
Let's go. Roll, Ed. Roll.
Mark.
Slow.
Everybody else, go, come on. Let's go, guys.
Come on. Speed it up.
Let's go, guys. Watch the lights. Let's go, guys.
Let's go, guys. Move it, agent. Come on, back up a little. Get in. Come on, try to make that out of the way. Thank you.
Here you go.
Coming up on the lights, guys. Watch your lights.
Come on, guys. Get behind. I'm sorry. Watch it. I got you.
There you go.
That's it. Now keep moving. Keep backing
up. Good pace, guys.
All right.
Good pace.
Watch your feet, people.
Watch a lot. You're coming up on lights again.
Come on.
Light.
Estaba con un caño en la mano, ¿viste?
Yo
estaba con un caño.
¿Eh?
Oh, proč?
Právě jsem o tom myslel.
Tak jo.
Yeltsin was here, he and President Havel went out for a beer. Now, I told you you don't want to go out for a beer.
Oh, no, that's not true. I told President Havel that when we finished our work tonight, I'd like to walk across this bridge because I did it 24 years ago. That was my only request. I said, after that, I'd like to go wherever you'd like to go. If you want to go out to a pub and have a little something to eat, or if you want to go hear music, he's a big jazz music fan, and I am too. So maybe he'll take me to one of these famous jazz clubs.
In your opinion, what's the news of the day?
That NATO adopted this partnership for peace and is reaching out to the countries of Central and Eastern Europe and to the former Republic, the Republic of the former Soviet Union, even Russia, and inviting them to enter into a partnership in which they work together for common security, promise not to invade their neighbors, but instead to respect them, and that we are going to, in effect, rewrite the map of Europe and perhaps have a future in which Europe is united, not divided, for the first time ever in all of history.
I've been talking to some Czechs today, great fans of yours, they love the United States, they use the word appeasement. They've been through appeasement before, and they fear that with the best of intentions, what you're doing now is leading an appeasement movement.
There's a big difference between now and what happened with appeasement. In the time of appeasement before the Second War, Germany was governed by Hitler, who was driven by expansionist impulses. Russia is now governed by Yeltsin, who completed the withdrawal of Russian troops from the Soviet Empire and welcomed the independence of the republics in the former Soviet Union. There are forces in Russia of aggression still, but they don't control the country. Furthermore, unlike the time of appeasement, when the Europe and the United States just walked away from Poland, for example, and other countries, we have offered them a genuine military partnership, joint training, joint exercise, sharing of some equipment, and the prospect of full membership in NATO. So it's not appeasement, it's very different. What we're doing is moving to provide security guarantees to them in a way that doesn't simply draw another line through Europe that's a little further east, but gives Europe a chance for the first time ever to be completely integrated with democracies, with market economies, and with mutual respect for territorial boundaries. So what we're doing today is avoiding appeasement, but we're not assuming the worst about history, we're working for the best.
You know this new thought that says that this benign view of even Yeltsin, certainly of Russia and its history, is a dangerous delusion.
Well, if it turns out to be wrong, then we will have taken all the steps necessary to protect these countries and to bring them into the Russian alliance. That's what we're doing here. But we don't want to send a signal to Russia right now that we assume that their future is going to be just like their past has been, when clearly they have tried to avoid it. I mean, Yeltsin has taken his troops out of Lithuania, promising to take them out of Estonia and Latvia, and been actively engaged in effect dismantling the entire Soviet empire. Gorbachev before him, even before the reign of communism, was clearly committed to moving out of Eastern Europe. So I think we should give new Russia a chance without in any way relaxing our commitment to the security of these nations. We're increasing our commitment to the security of Eastern Europe by asking them to join this partnership in NATO.
Speaking of the security of Central Europe and above, has the United States and Western Europe, through their weakness, encouraged the surge in their campaign of terror?
Well, as you know, all along I have favored lifting the arms embargo and using air power to prevent the shipping of Sarajevo and other destruction until I thought that at least it was a fair fight. I hope that by reaffirming our intention to use air power in the event the Serbs resume heavy shelling at Sarajevo and threatening it, and that the Allies finally believe it and mean it this time. And I was encouraged, frankly, that the British and the French, who have soldiers on the ground in Bosnia, there are Allied soldiers on the ground trying to keep as many people alive as possible. They've asked our military commanders for a plan to open the airport at Tuzla and to guarantee the troop rotation in Srebrenica, both of which could require the use of air power. So I think that there is clearly a stiffening resolve to try to do whatever we can to get these parties to agree. On the other hand, there aren't enough soldiers in the Western Alliance to occupy all of Bosnia and Herzegovina, and those people are going to have to decide to quit fighting one another. And what we got to do is impress upon them the fact that we will help them to keep the peace, and that right now they're very close to the elements of the deal that would have to be something like a deal that would be made if they kill each other for five more years.
Mr. President, you know the Serbs think this is a four-part flush they want to bluff.
Well, they may or may not. All I can tell you is the Secretary General of NATO, Manfred Vorm, and I both pleaded with the interest of our allies not to vote for this language to protect Sarajevo unless they meant to use it. We pleaded with them not to do it unless they meant to use it. So now, first and foremost, what happens depends upon the conduct of the Serbs. If they are abusive in their treatment of Sarajevo, or if they will not permit the UN mission to proceed as Srebrenica, then we will see whether the NATO allies mean business. I have to believe they do, since we talked so much about this before the resolution was voted on.
Mr. President, I want to get back to Russia for a moment. Are you going to Moscow believing you placed too heavy a bet on Yeltsin and wanting to spread that out a little bit? There is a school of thought that says, listen, President Clinton has gone too far in Yeltsin. That's dangerous.
Oh, I don't think so, because all along we supported Yeltsin not because he was Yeltsin, but because of what he stood for. He was, until the last elections, the only democratically elected person in Russia. There was no alternative legitimate parliament until the last election. And he had followed the precepts that we supported. That is, he took a non-interventionist line and supported independence for Eastern Europe. He supported the economic reform at home. He supported the free elections and democracy at home. As long as he is the elected leader of Russia and he embodies those ideals, we will, of course, support him. But now that there has been elections, there are other sources of legitimacy in Russia, something that I think is a great comfort to him. And we will have contact with those people, too.
Mr. President, you're here to talk about foreign policy, and I know. But it's my responsibility to ask two Democratic senators today to call for a special prosecutor in the quote white water case.
Well, they call for a special counsel, that's the issue.
Right. Are you opposed to that?
Well, first of all, I'm letting that be handled back home. I can tell you this. I didn't do anything wrong. I made an investment and lost money. I then spent more money to document that we've lost the money. All the federal investigators in the world have looked into this. Not a single soul has alleged that I've done anything wrong. So it is bewildering to me why, in the face of all the investigation that's been done of other things, and nobody saying I've done anything wrong, that it keeps being stirred. But I think we ought to answer questions. I think we ought to be accountable. On the chance that any information we have would be valuable to the Justice Department, we gave it all to them. And then people said, well, that's not enough. So I think we have to evaluate that and see where we are. The most important thing to me is, and the most important thing to the American people know is, I'm completely relaxed about this because I didn't do anything wrong, except I made a bad business judgment, which a lot of people have done in their lives.
Last question. Who do you like to shoot the ball?
I've got enough calls to make. I have a favorite, but it's a secret.
I appreciate it very much.
Thank you.
You can stay.
Move on, keep on going now. Keep on going.
Nobody in there.
Nobody.
Nobody goes in.
Twenty-four years ago today, this lady's mother showed me through Prague.
Really?
And took people all around. President Havel found them for me and brought them here. Their son went to Oxford with me, and we were in the same college, and we played basketball together. And when he knew I was coming through Czechoslovakia on my way back from my now famous trip to Russia, he invited me to stay with his parents. So I lived with them. I spent a week with them 24 years ago, this week, this same week. And she was looking in her notes and found that her mother, who lived with them, had taken me through Prague, taken me to the monastery and a lot of other places on this day, this exact day 24 years ago.
Did you come here?
No. This is a little upscale for me.
What's
what
sort of
changes
that?
It's a remarkable
thing. Amazing. It's an amazing. It was even then a gorgeous city. And the only thing I asked the president to do is if we could walk across the bridge together. Because it had such a big impact on me so long ago. But looking at it, it's a dramatically different. Great tribute to him.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Let's go. Thank you. All right, guys.
It's a ticker. It's a ticker tape parade.
It's a ticker tape.
Okay, it's a notebook paper parade.
When I knew.
Got a phone.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.